Hi, everybody. My name is Carl Hohenstein. I'm a Solutions Engineering Manager with Viavi, and I'm here today to take a few minutes to walk you through our latest demo scenario. So let's get started. I think this has probably happened to all of you out there at one point or another. So we call this our Corporate Internet Analysis Scenario, or CIA. So let me paint a picture for you, right? You have users from multiple sites complaining that access to a key business application. In our case, we're using the corporate intranet, but it can be any key business application. Everybody uses the intranet, right? It's periodically been very slow, and it's obviously hampering their ability to get things done. And there's some other critical applications that are also being affected. So as usual, everybody's calling in, everybody's complaining, everybody wants better performance. So the two key issues again, this application's used by many people across multiple sites. This application is used daily by many people at all sites across the company. And the usual finger pointing and all hands calls are in progress, and the leaders want an explanation and mediation as soon as they possibly can. So I'm going to take you into our Absorber solution. And of course, we're going to start with our patented end user experience score. And you can see immediately on this screen with just two windows or two widgets that we obviously have a problem. Whether you look at the map and you see a yellow and red circles, which obviously are not good, or you look at our end user experience score by site, which is where I am, you can see that something happened in this time frame here. It was bad, it got a little better, and then it cleared up, which is good, but we want to make sure it doesn't happen again. So looking at our end user experience scores for the different sites, it really doesn't matter which one I pick. We need to find out what the problem is. What was the domain? Who's responsible for fixing it? So let's take a look at Toronto and see what we got there. Clearly, it's a network problem. And you can see round-trip network delays, if you read it, packet loss and retransmission, delaying connection setup, a bunch of problems with the network. But let's not just believe one of them. Let's close that, and I don't know, let's look at Dallas. A little better, but not great. Network, one more, just to make the point, let's try Minneapolis. Okay, we've obviously got a network problem. We do not have a client problem, a server problem, or an application problem. So through the ease of use with the Observer UI, the next obvious step would probably, if I looked over on the left, to go to network analysis. So I'm zero clicks in, I'm headed towards my first click now. Clicking on network analysis and letting the screen paint for a sec, we see something interesting. This is the same map that you saw when we were under sites, same problem. What you're seeing very quickly, again, hopefully in a simple three-grid model here, is you're seeing some spikes in network utilization. Now, we don't know if that's good or bad looking at that graph, but if you remember when we looked at the EUE score, we know it's bad. That's measuring the actual end user experience of your end users or your customers. So we know that's bad. We know it's out of baseline, and we know it's a network problem. So this is a nice accompanying graph that shows you that we are having utilization spikes, which is interesting. But what really brings it home is when we come over to the lower right-hand side and we take a look at what appears to be very normal traffic here. And there's our CIA or corporate internet application. But what do we have as our number one application during that time frame? We have backup traffic. And in this particular case, it's site to data center backup traffic that obviously shouldn't be there or shouldn't be there in that volume, certainly during the day when this problem is happening. So that's interesting. With one click, we've already kind of learned that we did have a utilization spike, but the idea is not to increase bandwidth because we don't have a critical business application taking up that bandwidth. We have something that shouldn't be there. Could be backup traffic, could be anything. Obviously, in this case, it's backup traffic. So what do we really want to know now? That's great that we kind of know that there's backup traffic on the link, but the next question I have, and hopefully you have, is who or what's causing it? So I'm going to, if you allow me, a three whole clicks, I'm going to make one more click in this presentation to get us to kind of the root cause. And I'm going to click on forensics. Now, what forensics is doing, it is bringing in flow data into Observer. We had previously been looking at packet data, but you didn't really need to know that to solve the problem. I'm showing you that in the video presentation. The key is I didn't have to go anywhere. I am in the same solution and I am migrating the packet and flow data together to solve a problem. So now we're looking at this screen and we see something that's a little bit more obvious. We see the spike of backup traffic when it actually occurred. We certainly see all the other legitimate applications that are out there. And we can see, here's what we care about, that corporate internet or intranet or whatever application that is critical to you. And we see the volume there, and we see almost a 2.5-3 times amount of volume backup traffic that should not be there. So that's great, but I haven't told you anything new yet. I promised I'd tell you who the culprits are. Well, that's pretty simple. All we need to do is drill down, and we go to a conversation table. So I guess 4 clicks. As you can see here, we've identified the backup server and the backup client that was responsible for kicking off the backup process. Now, the real life scenario here, just to bring it back home, what happened is this process that was supposed to run at 12 or 1 a.m. in the morning was actually running at 10 or 11 a.m. in the morning. And you could see that why that would cause massive problems. So the fix was easy here. And the reason that you saw it go away is because the person responsible for misconfiguring the backup simply went in and fixed it. Now, if this had been other types of rogue traffic, like people streaming audio or streaming video, the fix obviously would have been a firewall rule or perhaps a company notification or something like that. But it doesn't really matter, as I said, what it was. The idea was is that folks couldn't get their work done because of some type of rogue traffic. So in conclusion, with just a few clicks, we resolved a problem affecting basically all users in just a few minutes or even less. We identified the problem domain, the reason for the bandwidth not being available, and the user responsible for the interruption. By rescheduling the backup, as I said, we also prevented a reoccurrence. So the key takeaways are, this demo should be applicable to your organization, because what we're really showing here is you have a mission-critical application or applications. You have something that's interrupting that service to your critical end users. They can't get their work done. We can identify that something, whether it's backup traffic, whether it's video or audio streaming, no matter what it is, and we can make the determination to get to a root cause fix. Now, let's say that we went in and we saw that it was an exponential amount of legitimate traffic. Well, that helps you plan for a bandwidth upgrade, but either way, you get to the correct root cause. Thank you for your time. I hope you've enjoyed this brief presentation. And if you have any questions about this video, any video in the series, or any questions about the Observer Viavi platform, please fill out the form that you'll see on the right-hand side of the page.